Hello friends, in this lesson I will explain the structure and the working principle of GFETs, which are the basis of voltage control field effect transistor used in electronic circuit switching tasks. As you can see here, we can study FETs in two main groups. In this lesson I will describe GFET. GFET's abbreviation consists of the initials of the words junction field effect transistor. On the left, you see the shape of the GFET transistor, and on the right, the symbol. The GFET transistor has three pins. One of them is gate, the other one is drain, and the last one is source. They are denoted by the abbreviations G, D, and S. Their locations are not always like this, they can change. In its symbol, gate, drain and source pins are like this. So, how does the GFET transistor work? With a small trigger voltage coming from the gate, a large current is controlled from drain to source. We can compare the GFET transistor to a faucet. The valve of the faucet is gate and the direction of water is between drain and source. In other words, while controlling the current in the transistor, we can control the flow of water in the faucet. When we open the valve, we control the water. In the symbol, if the direction of the arrow on the gate pin shows inside, it is N channel, and if it shows outside, it is P channel. So, what is the difference between them? To trigger N channel GFET, the negative pin of the connected source must be connected to the gate of the GFET and the positive pin to the source. The connection in P channel is vice versa. The positive pin of the source must be connected to the gate of GFET and the negative pin to the source. This is the difference between the two types. The voltage value of the source connected between gate and source and the current value between drain and source are checked in both. So, how does a GFET transistor work then? Let's have a look. Based on this example, we can easily understand the working principle of GFET. As you can see here, there is a P-channel GFET, a small DC motor, and a 12 volt power source to start this motor. Now, let's check the speed of this motor. We supplied the motor with 12 volt voltage. We also linked a source between GFET's gate and its source to control its speed. We can adjust the value of current between the voltage value of this source and GFET's drain and source. In other words, we control the current by voltage. It should be noted here that there is never a trigger current at the gate pin of GFET. Drain current is controlled by voltage. If you remember, we checked the current and the current in the BJT transistor. In FET transistors, current is controlled by voltage. Here, you can see that the voltage source connected between gate and source is 1 volt. In this way, a current flows between drain and source. With this current, our motor rotates at a certain speed. Let's remove the 1 volt voltage source. When we remove the voltage source required for triggering, no current flows between drain and source. Let's connect 3 volt voltage source instead. In this way, we can see that the motor turns slower. So, the current between drain and source has decreased slightly. We have checked this current with a voltage source. Now, let's remove the 3 volt voltage source and connect 5 volt voltage source this time. Here, we can see that the motor rotates slower. This shows us that the current between drain and source has decreased further. GFET transistor works on this principle. we can adjust the current flowing between drain and source according to the intensity of the voltage we connect between gate and source. Now, let's look at the Proteus simulation. The working principle of the JFET transistor, which is a variant of the FET transistor, can be explained basically in this way. I hope it was useful for you and you enjoyed it. Hope to see you in our next lesson. Goodbye.